Hello everyone. In our last video, we have studied about the spermatogenesis and oogenesis. Now in this video, we have to see fertilization and implantation. So let us go through it. Okay, so the first thing that we have to understand or we should know is the process of fertilization, which we already know actually. Fertilization, it is also called as syngamy. It is the fusion of gametes. Now in male, the male gamete is sperm. And in female, the female gamete is egg or ovum. So the fusion of this sperm and the ovum, it is called as zygote. And in humans, you will see that the fertilization is a kind of internal fertilization which takes place inside the body of the female. That is where it is internal fertilization. And the site of fertilization is the ampulla. We have seen the structure of fallopian tube or oviduct, in that we have seen the region of ampulla also. So there at the ampulla, in the ampulla, this fertilization takes place. And then further development of this zygote into the embryo and thus a child takes place inside the uterus. So this is the path of, or this is the path of development of a child, that the zygote, it develops or it fertilizes into the ampulla and then develops into the embryo. This is egg or ovum, which is having 23 chromosomes. The sperm also has 23 chromosomes, and when the fusion of this takes place, pairing of these takes place, then after fertilization, the zygote that we get, it contains 46 chromosomes. Now let us see the mechanism of fertilization. Semen released during the ejaculation has sperms and some secretion, and that remains coagulated. That means thick semen you will find in the male, which then get ejaculated in the female part, and after that it becomes liquefied. And when the sperm enter into the female body, they become active, and then the further development or further path of these sperm activation start. This we will see in next slide here. So this is the fertilization. We have to see the movement of sperm towards the egg. Two parts are shown over here. First, we will see how the sperm, it moves to the fertilization site, that is the ampulla. Okay. So sperms, when they enter into the female part, female reproductive part, through the penis, about 200 to 300 million sperms enter into the female body. From vagina, they enter into the female part, or female reproductive part. But here what happens, that vaginal pH is acidic. The environment of vagina is acidic, and because of this acidity also, the number of sperm that are entering, out of those sperm, few sperms get killed or destroyed. Moreover, this vaginal environment or vaginal antibodies or phagocytes, they think that the sperms are the foreign bodies, and that is why also the death of few sperms takes place in the vagina itself. So because of the acidity of vagina and because of the antibodies of the vagina also, few sperms get killed, and only about 200 to 300 can move towards the cervical canal. So they are moving somewhere here, and then they move to the uterus. They come to this part. Then here what happens, that the vaginal secretion, the secretion secreted by this vagina, act on the plasma membrane of the sperm. So these secretion are acting on the plasma membrane of the sperm because of what happens, that the removal of protein and carbohydrate from the plasma membrane of the sperm takes place. Okay, so sperm's plasma membrane layer of the protein and carbohydrate, it is getting removed because of the secretion. Okay, and this particular process is known as capacitation reaction. capacitation reaction is a reaction where the sperm's protein and carbohydrate are getting removed because of the secretion of the vagina. And you know, this is the good thing for the sperm, because after capacitation reaction, sperm become more active, extra active and motile. Their tail movement also increases tremendously, and because of that they can move with a higher speed towards where? Towards isthmus of the fallopian tube. Now after isthmus, or passing to isthmus, they goes to the ampulla, and ampulla is the fertilization site, right? Now let us see, that means they come somewhere here, ampulla. Okay, sperms, they are entering from this vagina, and then they are going to uterus. Before that, their plasma membrane, it getting weakened or getting removed, and then from here they move to isthmus and to the ampulla. Same thing also happens with the ovary. Ovary is releasing ovum, which is a secondary oocyte having a layer of zona pellucida, and outermost will be the corona radiata. So this much structure get released by the ovary, or the Graafian follicle, right? And then these fimbri, they catches this ovum, and then it moves to the infundibulum and then to the ampulla. So here from ovary, ovum is coming to ampulla, and from this side, this part, sperm is coming to the ampulla. So here now there will be the fusion of sperm and egg at the ampulla. See, this ampulla is the site of fertilization, where here, because here actual fusion will takes place. This is the same thing that we have seen, will be seeing in the next slide. Okay, now let us see the entry of sperm into the egg. Now at ampulla, sperm is there, ovum is also there. So the sperm will try to penetrate the ovum. How? Let us see. Few hundreds, we know that 200 to 300 millions sperms are entering into the female part, but only few hundred, maybe 200 or 300 only can manage to reach to the ampulla region. And out of those sperms also, only single sperm can fertilize the ovum. Not all those are reaching towards the ampulla side, they will fertilize the sperm. Ovum, but only single sperm, one sperm can only fertilize the ovum. Now here at ampulla, acrosome of sperm, it releases lysines, enzyme get released by the acrosome of the sperm, which penetrate through the corona radiata. It also releases certain corona penetrating enzyme. Because of that, the sperm can penetrate the corona radiata. And because of these enzymes, the lysines, corona penetrating enzyme, there will be a dissolution of the corona radiata. A layer of outermost layer of the ovum get dissolved because of the enzymes released by the sperm, acrosome of the sperm. So the acrosome of the sperm is releasing enzyme, because of that corona radiata get dissolved, and then it can pass through the sperm can pass through the corona radiata, and then it touches to the, or it comes to the layer of zona pellucida of the egg or the ovum. Sperm head passes through the zona pellucida. Now what happens over here? So zona pellucida, it has fertilizing receptor proteins. This enzyme is there, fertilizing receptor protein is there, which generally recognizes the human sperm. It has affinity towards the human sperm. It recognizes the human sperm, and here the receptors which are present at the zona pellucida layer are ZP3 and ZP2, which helps to burst the acrosome.
So the acrosome of the sperm get burst out here at the layer of zona pellucida because of the receptors of zona pellucida, and then fertilizin binds to the specific acid protein anti-fertilizin of the sperm. Fertilizin is of zona pellucida, and anti-fertilizin is of sperm, and these two brings about a attraction of sperm to the egg, which of course will enhance the chance of fertilization. Okay, and this interaction, this reaction of fertilizin of the zona pellucida and anti-fertilizin of the sperm, this interaction, this reaction is called as compatibility reaction. Right, this is compatibility reaction. Now next, so this is how sperm is now here near the layer of zona pellucida. It has crossed the corona radiata by releasing some enzymes. Then now it is there at the zona pellucida layer. Zona pellucida is also releasing some receptors, and the sperm is also releasing anti-fertilizing, and the reaction of these two is called as compatibility reaction. Now afterward, acrosome reaction takes place, which we will see in the next slide here. Now the entry of single sperm. Till now, till the corona radiata, we have seen that about 200 to 300 sperm can enter, but the fertilization will be done by the single sperm only, and the reaction will be called as acrosome reaction. So let us see what is it. Now the sperm head, which is at the zona pellucida layer, it touches the zona pellucida, and because of this, acrosome, which was about to burst at the zona pellucida, its covering rupture and it burst. Basically, acrosome, it ruptures or breaks or burst, and it releases lytic enzymes, acrosine or zona lysine. So this enzyme is released by the acrosome while bursting or while rupturing, and then because of these enzymes, the sperm head comes in contact with the small fertilization cone or cone of reception of the egg membrane. Now the egg membrane, ovum, it forms a fertilization cone or cone of reception, and because of the activity of this enzyme, the sperm head comes in contact with this fertilization cone, and then production of weak wave of depolarization of ovum takes place. This is basically depolarization of egg membrane is very necessary, because we know that the single sperm only can fertilize the ovum. So for the entry of single sperm only, for blocking, making a block for the other sperms, this depolarization is required. So because of these enzymes, depolarization of the ovum takes place, which is also known as fast block. And then the plasma membrane of both the cells dissolve at the point of contact. What is happening? Sperm, it touches the zona pellucida. Sperm across, it releases certain enzymes. And because of that, a small fertilization cone is formed at the egg membrane, and because of all these enzymes and the fertilization cone, there will be a weak wave of depolarization. Ovum become depolarized, and because of this depolarization, only single sperm can enter into the ovum. Okay, so the plasma membrane of both the cells, that is of sperm and of ovum, is dissolved now, so easily the sperm can enter into the egg. See, sperm nucleus and the centriole, nucleus and the centriole of the sperm, which will be called as, now it will be called as male pronucleus. So this male pronucleus will enter into the egg. Okay, but remember that the zona pellucida layer will remain as it is around the egg or the ovum. It has just depolarized. Because of that, a cone is formed and the sperm entered into the egg. But that layer remains as it is intact. And here, other parts of the sperm, they remain outside. Only the sperm nucleus enters into the egg. Other parts, it remain outside only. Now here, this is the phase when the pronucleus, it enters into the egg. At that time only, we have seen that the at the time of ovulation, the ovum was in a state of metaphase 2. That means meiosis 2 wasn't completed. Okay, so that meiosis 2 completes here after the entry of the nucleus of sperm. Then the metaphase 2, it proceed further and meiosis 2 takes place. Now we know that after meiosis, one ovum you will see, or a bigger structure and a smaller polar body will generate. So we will have one proper ovum now and polar body which will degenerate afterward. Now, after the completion of the meiosis 2, ovum releases certain chemicals. Male pronucleus is inside the ovum, and now the ovum is releasing certain chemicals. Because of that, what happens? Sperm head touches the vitellin membrane. Vitellin membrane, the membrane which was present around the nucleus of the ovum, inner to the zona pellucida. Vitellin membrane is present inner to the zona pellucida, surrounds the nucleus of the ovum. Here, a cortical reaction gets activated. Because of that, vitellin membrane, it changes into the fertilization membrane. And this takes place because of or by deactivating the sperm receptor of zona pellucida, which is known as slow block. Now the sperm nucleus is inside. Okay, so again, few sperms are there itself around the zona pellucida. Now we don't want those sperms to enter into the ovum does not want those sperms enter into the nucleus or near the nucleus. So what they do, they a cortical reaction gets activated. Because of that, vitellin membrane of the ovum, it changes to fertilization membrane, and this deactivate the receptors of zona pellucida, which is known as slow block. Now no other sperm can enter into the ovum. Okay, and this is this is how the polyspermy or entering of the many sperm or more than one sperm gets avoided, because of the slow block, because of the deactivation of the zona pellucida receptors. Okay, so this is how now only single sperm has entered into the egg. So inside the egg ovum, we have male pronucleus and ovum, the nucleus of the ovum, which is also known as female pronucleus. Now after this, after completion of all these steps, in a ovum we will be having male pronucleus and female pronucleus. Now the activation of ovum before fertilization was at metaphase 2. With the contact of the sperm head to the vitellin membrane of the egg, it get activated and it resume and complete meiosis 2. With this, it gives out a second polar body which will degenerate. The germinal vesicle organizes into female pronucleus. At this stage, it is true ovum or egg, which is ready for, this pronucleus is ready for fertilization. So secondary oocyte after completion of meiosis turned into female pronucleus and second polar body. Now this is of our interest because this is going to fuse with the male pronucleus. Let us see here. You can see over here the mature follicle, it is releasing ovum, ovulation is taking place, see ovum. Then at ampulla region, sperms are coming near the this ovum. After the penetration of sperm into the ovum, this is the nucleus of a sperm, which is known as male pronucleus. This is the nucleus of true egg or ovum, which is female pronucleus. So now we have male pronucleus, female pronucleuses here, which get fused together, and fertilization or syngamy, or you can say karyogamy, takes place. Karyogamy, because the two nucleuses are getting fused together, because of that it is also known as karyogamy. And after the fusion of these two nucleus, we get zygote, right? So this is how fertilization takes place. Significance of fertilization: secondary oocyte, it completes the process of oogenesis and is transformed into the mature ovum. In the fertilization process, mature ovum formation takes place. The diploid chromosome number is restored in the zygote by the process of syngamy. Because the sperm was of 23 chromosome, ovum was of 23 chromosome, and the zygote, it gets diploid chromosome, that is 46 chromosome, as a mature human body. The ovum lacks the centriole necessary for the further division are received from the sperm during fertilization. At the time of fertilization, ovum does not have centrioles. But then because of the sperm, it also gets the centriole for next division. Fertilization involves fusion of male and female gamete from the parents. It results in variation which are significant to evolution, because the characters are getting mixed of the male and female. And the sex of the offspring is also determined, because there in those 46 chromosomes, we'll have the sex chromosome also, XX and XY chromosome. And because of that, we can, or the sex of the offspring or the child can be determined, whether it will be a male child or the female child. Let us summarize this, whatever we have seen in this. So the sperm, it is getting released through the penis in the form of semen, and these sperms, they enter to the female reproductive part, goes to the uterus. In between, they get killed because of the vaginal secretion and because of the antibodies, which is known as capacitation reaction. Because of this capacitation reaction, sperm become active, very active. And then they move to the oviduct part called as ampulla. There they goes to the ampulla, where ovum is also coming. Then here acrosomal reaction takes place. Acrosome get dissolved. And because of the release of certain enzymes, then it touches to the here corona radiata. It dissolves. Then the sperm, it touches to the zona pellucida, where there will be a presence of receptors which will recognize the sperm, and because of that acrosome will also release certain enzymes. Because of that, cone will be formed at the zona pellucida layer, and from there the sperm can enter. Now the sperm is touching, or it is near the vitelline membrane of the ovum, which gets depolarized due to certain enzymes, which is also known as fast block. Because of that, other sperms cannot enter. Then at this time, ovum also releases certain chemicals. Because of that, receptors of zona pellucida also dissolves, which is known as slow block. Now this is the condition, this is the case where there is no entry of other sperm. It has blocked now. And now after this, after these blocks, male pronucleus is inside the ovum. At this stage, meiosis II gets completed of the ovum, because of that it produces one female pronuclease and second polar body. Now this female pronuclease is actually ovum or egg, and now here we have female pronuclease and male pronuclease together, which get fused and forms the zygote. Okay, here also in this diagram also you can see the sperm is trying to enter the corona radiata layer. Here capacitation reaction will take place. Before that only corona capacitation reaction will take place. Because of that it will move faster and will go to ovum. There it will dissolve the corona radiata layer by certain enzyme. Then it will move to the zona pellucida layer. See, this is the zona pellucida layer, and here the sperm is trying to enter into the zona pellucida layer. Here receptors are present, which recognizes the sperm, releases certain enzymes. Because of that cone is formed and the sperm can enter into the through the zona pellucida also. Now this ovum will release certain chemicals. Because of that receptors will get dissolved and block will form, so other sperm cannot enter. Now this sperm, it is coming in contact with the vitelline membrane, and then through this vitelline membrane only nucleus gets inside into the ovum. Only nucleus, you see here, this one is the nucleus, pronucleus, male pronucleus. Now this male pronucleus is inside the ovum. Ovum, it completes meiosis 2 and forms female pronucleus and polar body, which gets degenerated. Now this male and female pronucleases are getting fused to form zygote. So this is how fertilization gets completed. Okay, now next stage of fertilization is the embryonic development. Here what happens, that development of zygote gets started in the embryonic development. The zygote formed as a result of syngamy is activated to divide. Zygote starts to divide, and then after like few changes or after few division, the zygote will result into the matured organism or human organism. So zygote, it is also called as totipotent cell of the human body, because in human body this is the cell which has the ability to form a new organism or a matured or a developed organism. So that is why it is called as totipotent cell. Now this zygote undergoes certain divisions, and these divisions are known as cleavages. Now the zygote will undergo cleavage formation. Here also you can see certain cleavage formation are going on, which we will see in next slide. See here. Now fertilization has taken place. Zygote has formed, which is a totipotent cell of the human body. I have already told you that it has a capacity, it has an ability, potential to form a new organism through this single cell only. Now this zygote, it undergoes division. Mitosis takes place in the zygote. We know that after mitosis the chromosome number remains as it is in the daughter cells also. Okay, so the chromosome number is not going to change after these divisions, and these divisions or the mitosis process, it is known as cleavage in case of zygote division. Okay, this is a special kind of division or mitosis, you can say, which is known as cleavage. Now after first cleavage or after first division, this zygote, fertilized zygote, it forms two cells, and this stage is known as two-celled stage. Remember that after fertilization also zona pellucida was retained around the embryo. So here around this fertilized egg, zona pellucida layer is as it is. So here whatever divisions will take place inside the zona pellucida layer only. So here only the formation of cells takes place, new cells takes place. Okay, this will not grow in size inside this specific side, size only division will take place, right? So now fertilized egg has divided into two cells. These two cells again will divide mitotically, or next cleavage will occur, and because of the next cleavage, these two cells will give rise to four cells. Okay, and the cells which are forming, new cells which are forming here, are called as blastomeres. These cells, one cell is called as blastomere. Okay, and the cells, they are blastomeres. So two cell stage turned into four celled stage, and this is how the division will continue. This cleavage formation will continue with these cells. Blastomeres will again divide mitotically, will divide, and one stage will come where there will be a presence of 8 to 16 cells. Near about 16 cells will be there, which is called as 8 cells stage. And at this stage, this structure is known as morula. Okay. After cleavages, after divisions, these blastomeres again divide and forms 8 cells inside the zona pellucida layer only, which is known as morula. Okay, so after these cleavages, 1 8 cell structure will form, which is known as morula, and this morula now will start to move from ampulla region towards the uterus. After formation of morula, morula stage will occur in ampulla region only. That means whatever these divisions are taking place in the ampulla only. Fertilization though was occurred in ampulla, then 2 cell stage, 4 cell stage, and 8 cell stage will occur in ampulla region only. So morula gets developed or formed in the ampulla region, and then from this ampulla region, the 8 cell structure, or you can say morula, is started moving towards the uterus. Now it reaches to the isthmus. Morula at the third day, you can say it reaches to the isthmus, and by the end of the fourth day it reaches to the uterus. Remember now that this complete female body is in its menstrual cycle only. Okay, and whatever changes we are going through here are the changes after ovulation. Now, after 4 days, the female reproductive system is in its secretory phase or luteinizing phase. Okay, the cycle is going on, right? So it is in secretory phase now. Let us go through this also. Once the first cleavage in the zygote is meridional and occurs at about 30 hours after fertilization. First cleavage will form or will occur after 30 hours of fertilization. It divides longitudinally into two blastomeres. After longitudinal division, two blastomeres will form, two cell stage. And the second cleavage is also longitudinal, but at the right angle to the first one. And this also occurs after 30 hours of first cleavage. That means after two cell stage. Third cleavage, here we'll get a four celled stage. Third cleavage is horizontal. And after third cleavage, we will get eight cell stage, which is known as morula. Right? And now this morula has started to move towards the isthmus, and then it will go to the uterus. Here also you can see zygote is there. Because of the first cleavage, two cell stage we got, then three cell and then four cell stage. This is the second cleavage. And after third cleavage, we got morula. in female part also you can see this. This is the oocyte after ovulation. This is the oocyte. This is the zero day of fertilization. Fertilization has taken place. We have got the zygote now here. Zero day of fertilization, that means sperm is going to enter here now. Two nucleuses you can see over here. No, sorry, here only. Fertilization will take place. We will get a zygote. Now this zygote will undergo the first cleavage. Day one after fertilization. First cleavage has formed. Because of that we got the two cell stage. Then we got the forced cell stage. And now 8 cell stage. This is the morula. Morula is at the isthmus. Then it is moving towards the uterus now. Okay, these changes we will see now. Let me tell you that this morula, when it grows or develops into the other stages, it start to embed into the endometrium wall of the uterus. This is the endometrium wall. It starts to penetrate or goes inside the endometrial wall, and then the further development takes place inside this endometrium wall only. Now the morula, it turns into the blastula, and the process of formation of blastula is known as blastulation. Let us see in next slide. These are again cleavages. See here, zygote does turn into this 2 cell stage, then 4 cell stage, then 8 cell stage, then morula forms, and morula finally turns into the blastocyte. The process of development of morula into blastocyte or blastula, you can call it as blastula also, is known as blastulation. So now we have to see this development, morula to blastocyst or blastula. Let us see. So here, uterus is at the fourth day in its secretory phase, and we have studied in the menstrual cycle that at the secretory phase, endometrium of the uterus, it start to release glycogen. So here now our morula is in the uterus, there endometrium is releasing glycogen. So this glycogen, it is providing nutrition to the morula. Basically this glycogen try to enter into the morula. Okay, now the morula is showing presence of glycogen also. So morula developed to the embryo. We can call it as an embryo, but in later stages we will properly called this structure embryo. But for now, this morula, it becomes multicellular blastocyst now after the entry of glycogen into the morula. This morula, it remains floating in the uterine cavity for 2 to 4 days after its entry. So now again for 2 to 4 days it is in the uterine cavity only. Till now it has not entered into the endometrium, but till the end of 7th day it happens. See here, the outer layer of a cell is called as trophoblast. Now this morula has turned into the blastocyst. Morula, after getting glycogen, turned into blastocyst. See, this is the blastocyst basically. Okay, the structure that you are getting here is the blastocyst. Then this blastocyst, it shows certain developments after or at the end of 7th day. The outer layer of the blastocyst, this is the blastocyst, outer layer of blastocyst, it is called as trophoblast. See here, the outer layer, it is called as trophoblast. Okay, trophoblast begin to absorb the glycogen. Glycogen was released by the endometrium. So this blastocyst get filled with the glycogen. Here glycogen will be there. More fluid entering inside the blastocyst form the cavity. Glycogen will enter and it will form a cavity. You can see the cavity, hollow space over there. which get filled with the fluid, which is known as blastocyst. This cavity is known as blastocyst. Here you can see zona pellucida layer is as it is. Inside the zona pellucida layer, you will have a trophoblast layer. Inside the trophoblast layer, there will be a cavity which is known as blastocyst. And now the few cells of those who are present in morula, they get gathered over here somewhere at a point. Okay, this is known as inner cell mass. Inner large cells form inner cell mass or embryoblast, which remains attached to the trophoblast on only one side. These trophoblast cell and inner mass cells are basically the cells of morula, or you can say blastomeres only. These are the blastomeres which are getting arranged in the blastocyst or blastula. Okay, few cells are arranged at the periphery, outer layer. They have arranged themselves at the outer layer, and thus they are known as trophoblast. Few blastomeres have arranged themselves at one point attached towards the trophoblast. Now they are called as internal cell mass, which is also known as embryoblast. Okay, now by the end of 7th day, the blastocyst, it is fully formed, fully developed. Now it is ready for the implantation. Okay, let us once again see this. Morula is in uterus now. Endometrium is releasing glycogen. This glycogen, it is going to the morula. Thus, morula is now known as a blastocyst. And the cells which were present in morula, that is blastomere, they arranged themselves somewhere in the blastocyst. Few cells arranged at the periphery, known as trophoblast. Few cells arranged themselves together at a point which is known as internal cell mass or embryoblast. Now, blastocyst is completely developed and now it is ready for implantation. After that also, few changes take place in the blastula, which we will see later on. Let us see implantation now. The blastocyst, after its formation, gets implanted or embedded into the endometrium of the uterus. See here, this is blastula which is getting embedded, which is entering into the endometrium wall. This is the endometrium, and this blastula, it is getting embedded, it is entering into the wall, which is known as implantation. And this process usually begins on the 7th day after fertilization, and by the end of 10th day, the embryo is completely buried inside the endometrium. That means it completely goes inside the endometrium. The lytic enzymes secreted by the trophoblast rupture the endometrial cell, thereby making a burrow. So the trophoblast, which was the outermost layer of the blastula, it releases enzymes. Because of that, the endometrium wall, it ruptures and makes an entry for the blastula, into which the embryo begins to get implanted. Now it is getting implanted. By the end of 10th day, the whole embryo is deeply embedded into the endometrium, completing the process of implantation. So after 10th day, implantation process or getting inside the endometrium vault takes place. So this is implantation. Here in this diagram also, complete summary, you can see after ovulation, ovum is released, sperms are coming. These sperms are releasing nucleus into the ovum. We have the egg nucleus also getting fused, forming zygote. Then this zygote is undergoing cleavages. After first cleavage, we get 2-cell stage. Second cleavage gives us 4-cell stage. Third cleavage gives 8-cell stage. Now, this is after, you can say, 16 cells. It is called as morula, which then converts into or develops into the blastocyst or blastula. Now, here in blastula, Few blastomeres, they arrange themselves at the periphery known as trophoblast. Few arrange themselves at a point known as embryoblast. And the cavity also get formed because of the glycogen filling, which is known as blastocoel. So this is blastocyst, which get embedded into the endometrium of the uterus. So this is how implantation completes. Okay, so that was all about the fertilization and implantation. Now in our next video, we will see about the next processes or next development of this blastocyst.